I'm wearing shorts because it's 14 degrees in Canada. Hi again. It's just hi for you guys. Let me give you the story on that. I've wanted to do YouTube for a really long time. And I was like, oh, I'm in quarantine, got nothing to do, Sarah, let's get it. Let's make your first YouTube video. And I did. I filmed a Q&A, and like, Q&A's can be boring, but I was on my game, pretty funny, it was a good time. I thought I did pretty well. It was a good video. I edited it on a new editing software that I was trying. So I have this editing software. I'm editing my video. It takes a while. I'm pretty proud of it. It's pretty good. Get some nice jump cuts. Vibing! And then I realized that I can't export the video without it having a huge watermark on it. Or I would have to pay for it. And that is not what I was trying to do. I was not trying to pay for it. So that didn't work. But I have now found a new editing software which you can export without a watermark. And it's free. It's great. I'm vibing with it. Love it. So basically what that video covered was I'm Sarah. I just turned 18. I just cut my hair. I live in Canada. I'm graduating this year. I'm in quarantine, obviously. I have nothing to do. I'm really bored. I'm quarantined with my parents, my sibling, and my dog. I have one dog. I miss my friends. So now that we've got that covered, let's move on to... Sorry, I can see some kid in his window. It looks like he's using his hands like telescopes and staring out. I'm kind of creeped out. Let's move on to what this video is. Here's the basic premise of how I got this idea. There's a lot of people, even before this, who post like songs on their stories like that they really like, that they're listening to right now, that kind of fits their mood, their vibe that day. And then because of quarantine, there's been like these resurfacing of the like 30-day song challenges that a lot of people are putting on their stories. And I'll admit, I did do one. But more importantly, there's these memes going around that are all like, oh, no one cares about your 30-day song challenge. No one's listening to the songs on your story, blah, blah, blah. And personally, I don't care if someone posts songs on their story. Like, it doesn't bother me at all. Like, I don't get annoyed by it. I don't listen to it, but I really don't care. Like these tweets are implying that it pisses people off, and I'm like, I really don't care. So that's like the one part of it. And then the second part of it, I was like, okay, so I'm gonna be the person that listens to this. Now, I follow a wide variety of people on Instagram. And that's not to say that I have a lot of friends, because I really don't, but I follow a lot of people that I've just like met once. And so everything, like, it ranges from like celebrities to influencers to people I know from school to people I know from church to people I know through other people to people I know through my ex to people I know through my other ex to just, it's a wide range of people. And so that means that they have a wide range of music tastes. If someone liked to tell this kid to stop looking through his window, that would really make me a lot more comfortable. So it's like, Sarah, how do you expect to like any of these songs or like a wide variety of these songs if there's so many different people? Well, let me tell you, I like to think that I have like a really very expansive music taste, very developed palette, a very developed palette. I would say. I think of myself as better than a lot of people. Because my music taste comes from, I take all the songs that my friends like and I put them onto my playlist. And I take the sad songs and songs that make me cry and I put them on my playlist. And then I have the songs I've heard from my parents, which are like 70s to 90s rock and country, and I put them on my playlist. And then I've been into country due to like some of my friends and stuff, so that goes in. And I just have, and then I like also like pop alternative from like right now, so I just have this wide variety of music all put in. And so I think of it as better than a lot of people. I just think I have a really developed music taste, and so I think I'm the best person to look at these songs and rate them. Because that's, I haven't actually said that yet. This is what I'm doing. What I'm doing is I'm going through all the songs that I've seen on people's stories today, and I'm going to judge them. I'm going to rate them. I'm going to let you know what I think, because I'm just better. That's who I am, and that's what we're doing today, and we're going to get into it now. So we're going to start with the first song that I found, 1985 by Bowling for Soup. I've never heard of this band, and the person that I got it from has some, I would call it an interesting music taste from what I've seen on their stories. So we're going to see what that's like. Okay, honestly, that was kind of a bop in my opinion, kind of vibing with that. I'm gonna give that like an 8 out of 10. Kind of gives me Stacey's Mom vibes. Song number 2 is called Best Part by H.E.R. I don't know if you're supposed to pronounce that her, featuring Daniel Caesar. People actually have music tastes. I'm not the only one who can pick up good songs. Oh my god, the window kid is back. What are you doing? Where's your mom? I don't know, it was really bland though. So I'm gonna give it like a 5 out of 10. The next song is called More Than a Feeling by Boston. I have listened to Boston before. It's one of the more rock bands that I listen to from the 70s. Get ready for some rock vibes. Absolute bop. 9 out of 10. Love it. Whoever put this on their story, you go girl. Next is Apricot Princess by Rex Orange County. I've recently, just actually in quarantine, fallen in love with Rex Orange County. They're kind of a freaking bop. Wait, Renegade. I started watching Emma Chamberlain's videos. From the start, she's been like, Rex Orange County, a freaking bop. And I was like, say less. I'm gonna go listen to them. And I did, and I'm gonna be honest, my music palette just wasn't as, it wasn't where it is today. So I like listened to a couple of their songs and was like, this is not the vibe. I'm not feeling this. I'm really sorry, Emma Chamberlain. I love everything about you. But I can't do Rex Orange County. I just don't feel it. Now, I was starting to get into more songs that are very, like, vibey. Not, like, traditional that you would hear on the radio kind of thing. I'm not like other girls. I was like, let's give this another shot. And I listened to them, fell in love. And so I've already heard the song, obviously, quite recently, but we're gonna listen to it anyway. I will admit it's not my favorite song by Rex Orange County, but still Rex Orange County, I'm gonna give it like 7 out of 10. They're a bop. Next song is Heather by Colleen Gray. Okay,
band's really vibey.
Puts me in good mood. I like that song. I'm gonna give that an 8 out of 10 too. Kind of a vibe. Next song is called Jersey on the Wall by Tennille Towns. Never heard of this, never heard of the artist. It looks like it's country, so it could be a vibe. We'll see how it goes.
This jersey on the wall, the high school gym in the hometown. If I ever get to heaven, you know I got a long list of questions. How do you make a snowflake? Forgive me, I'm just asking.
I'm gonna be honest, I kind of hate her voice. Like, it's like when the people who like say they listen to country music, but they listen to Florida Georgia Line. I'm not saying I don't like Florida Georgia Line, but if you just listen to that, you don't listen to country. And I didn't grow up listening to country that much, and I'm a newbie here, I know that, in the country community. And I don't look like I'm country, and I don't own cowboy boots or anything. I'm really sorry, but that's what you listen to when you. That's the same as Florida Georgia. I'm sorry. I'm giving that 4 out of 10. So the next song is Smithereens by 21 Pilots. I am a fan of 21 Pilots. I have heard this song before. I really like this song. So here it is.
You know, I've always been collecting calm and chill. Step to a dude much bigger than me. Fuck you, I know. That would get me to smithereens.
8 out of 10 vibes, love it. Okay, this next one I'm actually really interested. It's called Golf on TV by Lemon Stella. I'm just excited to hear this. It's got a weird name. Makes me think maybe it's gonna be vibes. The person I got it from doesn't give me high hopes, but some people exceed your expectations, and sometimes you get your expectations high and they crush them. Let's find out which one this person is.
I woke up to the bed made in the downstairs. She thinks that she could for me. That's not something I'm used to. I keep going. Like it couldn't be real. If it's putting you first. Some people go for TV. And neither of those things make sense to me. You just be so consistent.
Okay, I like that. It's good. I'm gonna give that a 7 out of 10. Lemon Stella, you go girl. This last song I'm really excited for. So if it's bad, I'm gonna be really upset. It's called 17 by Youth Lagoon. That felt like what Rex or Orange County felt like to me a year ago. Like, it's not my vibe yet, but I feel like it could be. Like, I feel like she could be, but not yet. For now, I'll read it like a 6 out of 10. Okay, final thoughts on the song. People that I follow have better music taste than I thought, and I no longer... I still think of myself as better than other people. So thanks so much for watching. Thank you to all the people that posted these songs on their stories. Keep at it. You're doing great, sweetie. I will keep posting songs on my stories, whether people listen to them or not. I really don't care. I'm doing it for me. Because that's what's important. You gotta do it for you. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a like and comment below, whatever you want. Have a good day. Have a good quarantine. Find something to do. Have fun. I love you. Goodbye. No, that's weird. You're great. You're amazing, sweetie. Goodbye.